Morning, everybody. It is Saturday, November 26th, 7:48 a.m. I'm getting ready to start my day of one-on-one FaceTime and Skypes with our clubhouse members. I've done just put in a load of laundry and took care of a bunch of stuff. And sleeping is just not part of my program at all. I go to sleep about 1:30, 2 o'clock, and I'm usually up between 4 and 5. It's crazy. So I thought I'd throw a piece of music out real quick here, ahead of the game here. I'm going to go back to 1972. I don't believe I've looked up and I have not seen this. If I've posted it before, well, that's the way it goes. But this is an artist that I did named Shy Coltrane. I worked on her album. It was a self-titled album. And a little info on her is Shy Coltrane was born November 16th. She had a birthday 10 years ago. Happy birthday, Shy. She was born November 16th. I won't say the year. Is an American singer and pianist. Coltrane was born in Racine, Wisconsin, another Wisconsinite. Her mother was Canadian, her father a German violinist, and she grew up with six siblings. When she was 12, she gave her first piano performance. In 1970, she started the funk and blues band Chicago Coltrane. 2 years later, she signed a contract with Columbia Records, and her debut album was released. Her first single, Thunder and Lightning, which is off of this album, I didn't play on this track, though, was a hit. It reached number 17 on the Billboard charts. She enrolled in the Salter School of Music in Los Angeles and the following year released her second album, Let It Ride. This was followed by Greatest Hits and Best of Both in 1975 and The Road to Tomorrow in 1977. In 1977, she moved to Europe and lived there for several years. European new wave music influenced the three albums she recorded for Teldec during the 80s. After The Message, 1986, was her next album, appeared 10 years later, and it was a reissue of her, debut album. Oh, interesting. The players on this thing, there's a whole bunch of great players on this. Piano and organ were Shy Coltrane. Percussion on this was the incredible Victor Feldman, who's no longer with us, but Victor's one of the most gifted musicians I ever worked with. Monstrous pianist, but I did a lot of dates with him on percussion. Also, King Arison was playing percussion. On the track I'm going to play right now called Time to Come In, it was myself on bass, the great Ronnie Tutt, who played with Elvis for many, many years on drums, and Ben Benet on guitar. It was produced by Toxie French. Jim Horn did horn arrangements. Shy Coltrane and Toxie did the arrangements of the songs. Paul Buckmaster did string arrangements. It was engineered by Eric Prestige. God, I haven't seen Eric in years. The Billy Barnum, that was a different one. I'm just looking at all this. Mixed at Sound Labs, mastered at Artisan Sound Recorders. That's about it. So let me go ahead and play this track for you. It's called Time to Come In. This is Shy Coltrane. So here we go.
Well, I think that I've cried long enough, and I guess I've tried too hard, and I've had my share of worry, that's for sure.
Yeah.
kind of a nice way to kick off Saturday. Here, a little energy from Shy Coltrane and the gang. So I'm going to get running now. I got to get ready for my first call here. And I've got 20 people to talk to today, so I'm going to be sitting here in this chair till probably about 7 or 7:15 tonight. It's a long but really fun day. I love visiting everybody and catching up with them and just talking about life and everything in general. It's a unique side of doing the clubhouse. I'm also going to say, if anybody, you know, gets a chance, please pull up our immediate family, Toughest Girl in Town. It's the new single from the upcoming album. And if you could hit like on it, it would be fabulous. I'd really appreciate it. We're trying to get as much momentum going on this as we can. So if you could go to our YouTube channel, The Immediate Family, and subscribe to it. Don't cost nothing. Subscribe to it and click on like. It would be fabulous. Things are going really good with it. We've been doing really well with it. Like I've mentioned, we in the film festivals, we've won 3 audience favorite awards now. We made it in no particular order, but we made it into the top 10 of the New York Documentary Film Festival. And next weekend, next Friday, we will be in Aspen, Colorado, screening the movie. And next Saturday, a week from today, we will be playing a show in Aspen to kind of promote things and give people there that have seen the film a taste of where the band is now. So lots of stuff going on here, be in the studio on Monday with Jackson Brown, and Tuesday and Wednesday doing Tom Lerner's album with Dean Parks, Ned Albright, and Herman Matthews, and all kinds of good stuff going on. So just a moving target's always harder to hit. That's why I keep moving. So I'm going to wish everybody a fabulous weekend. It's gorgeous out, at least when I'm sitting here today. I'm going to be looking out. I got some really beautiful fall colors still on a tree that's outside my window. Everybody always goes, "Oh, he doesn't have any seasons." Well, if you plant for seasons, you have seasons. I just don't have, 8-foot snowdrifts to dig out of the house. But I've got trees all over my property that are all yellows and reds and browns, and there's vine on the house that's all changed color and is dropping its leaves now. So it feels very fall-like here. And I think theoretically, we'll be getting some rain over the next week, which would be really fantastic because God knows we need it. So take good care. I will be back tomorrow, and all the very best. Bye-bye.